Hello.
So,
yeah, Nilesh, you can continue because the candidate, when they are available, we don't know exactly. So, if they are available, we can go for Monday once again. Now you can continue, okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I will just show you one screen, some of the PDF. This is standard PDF, not made by me. This is SAP standard PDFs.
Okay.
You can see my screen, right?
Yeah, I'm able to see.
This is something like a functional overview of an e-recruitment. You can say the SAP e-recruiting. You can see under the global architecture, it supports 21 language.
Okay.
Again, the organization structure and data, which we have in the HR, we can build up here as well. Because when we recruit a candidate for a specific position,
okay,
a specific organization, we have to mention into the requisition for which organization and for which position we are hiring this candidate, the hiring is to be done.
Okay.
Second thing, the competency and qualification. I said the qualification catalog, which is there in the HR, also has the same qualification catalog in the e-recruitment. Because the same data is going to flow into the HR. And the report, including that the reporting is nothing but if a recruiter is creating some requisitions, then based on that, how many requisitions has to be done, how many candidates has been applied. So all sort of reportings are available there. That is a query. You might be aware of SQL query, the query view.
Yeah.
And those are available in the web as well, so which recruiter can see.
Okay.
And this is screening and selection tools, some of the which are available into the e-recruitment are dashboards. Dashboard is nothing but from where the candidate can have it everything. The recruiter. The recruiter can have can done everything from the single dashboard. Even he can see what the position he has created, what are the candidates who have applied for his the requisition who has. The division he has created, then the applicant tracking, the selection process, everything at one place, like a dashboard. You can say like dashboard itself signifies that the recruiter can do everything from the dashboard. Candidate selection list is available to you can see that which candidates have been selected, like a report as well, which gives list of selection candidate, questionnaires. I think you might be knowing. And prior to when we are even when we send your requisition or posting to the candidate, we ask some certain questions to the candidate, means like a date of birth, how many years of experience, and how soon he can join. Is he ready to relocate or not? Like an example, those are the first steps of questionnaires. Such questionnaires we can create itself in the recruitment web pages. We can rank the candidate based on his competition, skills, years of experience. Search and assign. Search is like same like an, we can search a candidate into the dashboard and we can assign the proper, you can say we can group the candidates. Grouping, you can say. As the company doesn't run on single profile, if we have a multiple sort of thing, it's like an HR, you can say, just like a department, I'm saying. HR department, IT department, and we have different departments in the company, admin department. So we can create such groups and we can search a particular candidate of particular profile or profile skills, and we can assign those to the respective groups. So these are some tools available. Robust applicant tracking. We can track easily the applicants by their activities. I need to find about his OFCC fee compliance. Actually, I'm not aware of this, so I will just check it out.
Okay.
And communication is nothing but we can have communication like in mails. For every activity, the candidate is going to get a mail. Like when he registered on our portal, he's going to get a mail. When he is assigned to any of the requisition, he's going to get a mail.
Okay.
When he's called for an interview, he's going to get a mail. So some such workflows are designed here. So
okay.
The communication is going to happen. But obviously, the call will be the manual process, which the HR is going to be done.
Okay.
And TRM, that is nothing but talent relationship management. Here,
what is it? Talent?
Relationship management.
Okay, TRM.
TRM, yeah. TRM is like a different module here in HR, but here we call it like a pool of a candidate where all the profiles of a candidate is available in the database pool. And internal as well as external. Internal, I would say here available because maybe of a person of one department may want to switch to the different department. So at that time, his profile or his competencies and everything should be available in our database, what exactly he does and what he wants and what is his goal and everything. Talent pipelining, it seems like it's just like in organizing your database here, the talent pipelining. This, as I said before, you just search a candidate and assign to a proper recognition, the proper group, and ranking, everything. And the communication here the same, email and letters, etc. And all these processes supported through the workflow. And integration, I said, recruitment can be run on different instance, I mean to say different server, or on the same server where the HR is running.
So the integration, in the sense, it is not like module integration, it is like the server integration, correct?
No, exactly, it is a module integration, but we have a sort of you can say it's a server integration, but indirectly we are by integrating the servers, we are integrating the modules. Means I want to say, we are integrating HR server with an EREC server, just to communicate between these two, as we are going to flow the data of e-recruitment to the HR. So indirectly the module got connected through this.
Certainly.
Even we have some fields, I don't know, in the EHP, I need to check, where we have a cost center as well, which will connect to the FIs.
Yeah.
Cost center is basically for the FI persons, and in the previous modules, it was not being connected to the FI module. We don't have integration with the FI module. That, if we want to do it, then it would be like in a separate development process to link the cost center with the FI. The cost center here is required. Just why it is required in the e-recruitment, basically, because all the cost required for the recruiting a candidate would be applied to one of the specific cost center, and they can manipulate all the cost what is happening for the e-recruitment for the specific position or requisition, you can say. So this is what the functional overview of the fee recruitment module does. And I think you might be aware of what exactly means we are going to have it into the course content. We're going to see the requisition management, administration of application process, application management, and TRM, that is talent relationship management. And we have some topics in it, like creating the requisition request, posting, requisition managements. So this is what exactly the basic of e-recruitment means, what the overview, you can say that.
So everything here we are doing through requisitions, actually.
I'm sorry?
Actually, we are more into like creating requisitions. This is plays a very important role here, like requisitions.
Yeah, definitely. Means we have very this as I earlier said, we have specific roles here, which I will just show it in PDF. Yeah, like manager, candidate, recruiter, and one is the administrator. Here is the administrator. So the manager is nothing but a manager will build a requisition. He will get the request. The requirement that we have this requirement and we want this person to be recruited. So he will build a requisition, or his assistant, maybe we can give it a role to his assistant or as well as to this manager. So he will build a requisition, or he can find it into the SAP system. This is to be done in the SAP ERP, SAP system, to SAP. then this requisition will flow to the recruiter, or same thing can be done by the recruiter as well. Because sometimes manager may send a mail to the recruiter and saying that, okay, I have such requirement, and can you please build a requisition, and can you please create a job opening for this. So the recruiter can do as well as the manager job, because the recruiter is the one who can do everything here. Then job of the recruiter is again creating the requisition and posting, search for candidates and candidate profile, track the applicants, and data transfer for the new hirees. So, and the role of administrator is that here means we have some profile or some candidates which are older than more than 3 months or 6 months, or some junk data. Clearance of those junk data is done by the administrator. Creating of such, deleting of such requisitions which are not required or which are maybe like a junk or something, those things. So some of these basic, some of this are the roles of the administrator. So you can see here, manager, create requisition request and forward requisition request. And this request goes to the recruiter, which complete requisition content, which will go over that and complete all the things and finalize the job posting, and it will publish the job postings. And then the role of a candidate after publishing the this job, it will be available on our portal. So candidate will come to our portal and search for our jobs and apply for our job posting. So these are some of the process or some of the roles which the person does.
But then once he applies, then he answers for the specific questions, and then immediately he will be receiving the call. As you said, like each and every sequence, he will be able to get a mail, correct?
Yep. Same. As soon as he applies for a job posting, even at that, there is a workflow which triggers that you have applied for some job posting, and that depends on our content. We can modify the content of the letter, saying that thanks for applying for a job. We will get back to you soon as we find your profile suitable for this or something like that, blah blah blah. Okay. And after that, if we find that particular candidate is suitable for our job or our posting, then we send a specific questionnaire to the candidate to fill out. He then answers, and then we receive a confirmation letter that he had got everything. So even now he can see the create and send rejection letter, receive rejection letter, receive invitation letter, receive offer and contract. So all sort of things it's happening through the workflow, and which is
here is just one small doubt. See, this offer and contract will be like an inbuilt, like letters or everything is inbuilt in the portal with just a click, the mail will be sent to the candidate, correct?
Yeah, actually we offers, the content of the offer will be the same in all the companies, but just the name and the position and everything are going to change. So for that we have a smart form or the Adobe forms build up here. So just on the click of that, it will get the required data, which are something like a dynamic, like a name of the candidate, the address of the candidate, the position of the candidate, and the joining date, and his salary, everything. So that is some dynamic fields which we populate into this Adobe form, and it will prepare that offer, and we can send it to a mail to a candidate. So, and all these things are now happening into the EHP 5. Earlier into EHP 3, there were some of the loopholes, or you can say it was not having those features which we have now into the
Like I could not get this. Earlier it was happening?
Earlier, like I said, when the candidate was registering himself on a job portal, he can enter his email ID like an abc@gmail.com. So we don't have a verification that this email ID is correct or not. But in that case, here it is asking like a pop-up. See, I will just show you the application wizard. The candidate gets logged in. And it's, once it is completing the application is submitted, let's show you that pop-up.
Oh, here you mean to say that we can also verify the email, whether the email is correct or not.
Correct. Because it actually gives a warning message that at least you have all the communication will send to this email. Please check your email is correct or not. Some of the information message is like that. It's going to the candidate. So this is sort of based something good. It's happening. And in HP3, we were having on VSP applications. Now the UI has changed to the web deeper applications. And earlier into the EHP3, we were having a BSP application where the tabs for the requisition were around 13 tabs. The recruiter has to navigate to total 13 or 11 tabs. But now it has reduced to, I think, 4 to 5 tabs, or 5 to 6 tabs.
Okay.
So they had just made this something very a good interface for a process now. I think that is in the PDF. ESP 4 and ESP 5, we got ESP 3, we got ESP 4 and ESP 5. ESP 4 and ESP 5.
Like, it is a version, is it? Correct? ESP 4, ESP 3, 4, 5, is it versions like?
They are the service pack menu.
Service?
Yeah, the announcement pack. You mentioned, not a service pack, but the announcement pack, which the SAP delivers when the particular body is get upgraded. Which release, we can say the release of a new announcement pack.
Like some ECC 6 or 7 like that, correct?
Yeah, you can say that.
ECC 5, 6, the same way.
Yeah. So these are some announcement packages on this cup. If SAP has announced some of the applications or some of the things into the ESP into the particular module, then they releases these things. So as in the HP3, I said all the web application on BSP applications, when they announced that, it went to this web improve. So they delivered this into the HP4. Then they made some corrections to some of the Adobe forms, then the email sending things and everything. Then they but obvious when the recipe has upgraded some of the things. There are some loopholes or something which are not been completed or which have some bugs.
Because it is like this only you face up like today. Actually, it is like something new Saturday. So many of my friends call it. So please get it.
Okay. Yeah. So in the HP4, when they delivered the HP4, they delivered with the web demo application, but there was something which was having a bug. So we applied some nodes, we raised some queries, and this was a standard issue. Then they create a node. So all these things, they accompanied into one thing, and when they release, when they upgrade, when they release this announcement pack, those nodes are already applied, coming into the market, and we have a new set of all applications. So this is something like an announcement pack. So all of those things, and here in the course content, I said the requisition creation, and what is the requisition posting, the administration process, what are the process template. Process template is nothing but we have a support team. Everything can't be done by the recruiter. We have a support team for that particular recruiter or something like that. And we have a process template. Means every company or every organization has its own process of recruitment. So for every profile, for every, you can say, like a manager. For manager, we will not be having, say, like, like a differentiate. Like for some company, we have background job verification, background job. So yeah, we have a background verification, but some company doesn't do that.
Yeah.
So some companies
also can be mapped into EREC, correct?
Yeah. So these are the things which are defined in the process, and we can follow that. Like this process template will be attached to the requisition, and we can while recruiting. For that particular requisition, then we can follow this process. Like for an example, I can give it is the best example. Like a senior manager positions and for recruiting a consultant, definitely a senior manager position manager will be having a different process to recruit. We will be not having the same process. So these things, that we define into process template. This is a position and we have this process to follow for this particular delivery.
Okay, then that person like senior positions may not be coming through all this channel, like they might be coming through different channels like that, correct?
Exactly. They might not go under every process, general process what the company follows. So there might be different things.
Yeah, they'll have their own, like it depends on company, like how the company decides.
Yeah. Company defines, in certain companies they have same process for all positions. They don't differentiate that. If it is a senior manager or even a CEO of a company, then they will go through the single process of a different. In that sense it's okay, but I don't think so it will happen. There will be different processes for everything. We will not be having a written test for a manager. Aptitude test for the manager. But for the freshers or for the candidate who has having 1 to 2 years of experience, the company may take a written test or aptitude test for that particular. So that we could define in the process template. Then the talent leadership management is nothing but the searching for the proper candidate. It's like a pool. It's like a pool database for our.
A pool of candidates, whoever is purchases the talent, then that person can be pooled, correct?
It is like the candidates who has registered to our portal, okay. And the internal candidates with the internal employees as well. Also the candidates which are came through references of our internal or external. All of this profile or resumes will be available in this talent pool. So before the company, but obviously I have seen this, the company when they have some requirement, they search internally first into their talent pool whether they have those candidates with the skill set available or not.
Correct.
With some latest profile with validity of last 3 months, updated resume with 3 months. So they go and search for those candidates, and if they are available, then they reach them, and if some of them joins, it's okay. If they still find that there are still vacancies, then they may post the job to the outside world. But before that, they search itself into their talent pool, because we I'm a candidate. If I'm interested in such a company, I will go to the portal and I will register myself, and my resume will be available with them in the talent pool. But I may not certainly go every time and check for the postings. Okay, this is a job I'm interested. I will go and apply. I may miss out or I may not look it after registration. So the recruiter does these things. He goes into talent agency management, search for a profile. If it is valid, then he pull out and he then may contact.
With this segmentation and target group, they do that, correct?
Yeah, the segmentation in target group is nothing but, they do the segmentation. Segmentation means different. Verticals. Yeah, you can say. There are some customer settings, but for talent warehouse, with SPR settings, the reportings, there are some standard reports, queries, and this is nothing but the SPR settings, system parameters, as system parameters are nothing but, I'll just show it here, for example.
What does it mean by system parameters actually?
That's what I will just show you an example here. coming to the technical settings, if you see the technical settings, these are some periodic services, handle unverified candidates, the candidates which are not verified. These periodic services will run on the period that we have defined. And it will do the proper action, means if he wants to delete or if he wants to message to a candidate that please update your resume or something like that, or please verify your details and everything like that. So these are some technical settings.
Okay, with this, in case sometime we can do the candidate verification, something or some other process, part of process, correct?
Yeah, the part of process you can say. Exactly. So system parameters are nothing but having here. Okay, I mean this means when I'm just creating the requisition, these are some the steps which you can see. There would be something like one step when you can see after completing the requisition, there will be some data overview where you will see the candidate is with all the data for the requisition, you will see what PDF. So we are defining the system parameters that I want this data will to be seen in PDF or into the HTML page or in .txt file. So these parameters we define in one of the table or one of the into the SPR settings. Then yeah, I don't have here that. I don't have a screenshot here, otherwise I haven't shown you here. Search engine here we, as I said, the TRM. TRM is nothing but the pool of a resume or the profile or the candidate profiles are dumped there. So definitely we need a search engine to search all those resumes. So we are using here the tracks, which is mostly widely used into the SAP. So here we're going to show what is the configuration for the track search engine, what we do at SAP into the SPRO, the settings for the search engine, how it is happening and everything. Periodic services, as I said before, periodic services will be to find the resume if they are 3 months older.
Oh, okay. Like that.
Yeah, that will be some periodic services. Are some of the resumes which will to delete the resumes which are more than 6 months old or which already
then automatically system delete those resumes.
Yeah, those are some based on the parameters and here it is for unverified candidates. Then they have just given one example, but I'm sure to when we do this technical settings, we can find it more. One of the periodic services for the indexing. Indexing is nothing but what we do there is whatever the resumes are available into the database, we index them after every 15 to 20 minutes so that it will when we search for a candidate, it will be a bit faster. This is one of the things that we need to do for the search engines. We have to index all the applications and everything. Reporting nothing but the queries, and as I said, that the user interface again means the Web Team Pro. Web Team Pro application.
I just have a small question here. Actually, what does this Web Team Pro use actually? Because many people say Web Team Pro, because I'm not aware of it. It might be a silly question, but I'm not aware of it as well.
Let me show you that. Web Team Pro is nothing but it's an application which runs on the web, when it's on the internet.
Okay, I understood that. Nice.
And to see the Web Team Pro application, we have to go into the SAT. Yeah, here it is something like this is application HRRCF underscore C underscore reference code search underscore UI. So this is the application will be running to search the postings which we have a reference code. When you might have received a mail from some companies, they said that this is the reference code for this job is REF0061. So this is the application when we create some requisition the posting and we publish on our portal, we have some reference code for them. If the candidate wants to apply to that job, then he can search for a particular reference code and he can apply. This is the application which is used here. And to run this particular web services, we have to create some reference users, which is part of process. Maybe I will guide you into this. This will be, I think, it will not. The recruitment process and the recruitment solution. Already, I think I have gone through the recruitment process. What recruitment process is? And the recruitment solution in that. I will just, when we are going to implement this project into some of the company, what are the steps that we need to follow with what we have to do it? That thing we have to find it. I think I don't have an authority to use this application. Yeah, this is something like a web application. So this would be the thing we are going to go through it.
And there was small query here. Mr. Nigel suggests I had doubt. See whether suppose now when I'm learning this EDIC course, then I'll be having certain server access by paying certain extra amount. Is there any other way that we can also get installed this portal, like we should see how we are getting installed? No, is there any way like that? Is there anybody available to install even portal? Because see, 1 month we can be into the server access, 2 months into the server access. So every month we can't buy the server, correct, sir?
Yeah, correct.
Is there any like ECC 6 version or something like that? Is this portal is also available somewhere outside in Hyderabad or somewhere like that? I just wanted to know if it's available or not.
That I really need to check because I haven't actually I never found that this thing to be done. My requirement.
No, this is just for the more into practice. That's it. Other than that, nothing. Because once you know how hands-on you have in the city, then that quickly you'll be able to answer the question.
Yeah, actually, if the person who works with SAP, I think for more than 3 or 4 years, then I think if he gets an overview of a particular module, then I think he can work himself.
But one thing I can say with you is I'm quite impressed with you. I'm really happy because you have explained each and everything in detail that has made me more happy. And one more thing I just wanted to know, do you have like only the training sessions with online, or do you also conduct a classroom session at LIT or something like that? I just wanted to know, only online or do you also have classroom sessions at LIT?
Just online, I don't have a classroom session.
Because I also have one small query, whether this online course is like compatible for learning or classroom sessions will not have the skills. That's what I just wanted to know. It's all the same. Or how do you feel? Because I just wanted to know. Because sometimes like I felt this classroom sessions wherein by interacting one-to-one and by just seeing the screen, showing the screen and explaining the screen in detail, that might give more love. That's what I'm just looking for. There's nothing else. Small query.
Actually, for my personal experience, I will go to go through like as a trainer. Means what exactly the trainer people does? They will go through the slides and everything. But I don't think so. I will go like that. I will be on the screens.
And one more thing, Mr. after this, are you going to explain any project or see, I just wanted to know because once our training is done, if I wanted to try in any companies or anything, so I just need to put some projects, correct or not?
I will be sharing my almost 2 to 3 projects that I did. This was almost 2 implementations.
Wherever you have worked, that can be fine. And like, at least tomorrow nobody will consider I know e-recruitment. At least if I say yes, this is the model, this is the project which I have worked. So if I put something in my resume or CV, so that should be give more action to my CV so that it quickly gets shortlisted. This is the only view. Because there is nothing else, Mr. Nilesh. I'm through with a few companies. Because of course, certain companies have been released their offer letters. Even I've been through TCS from Bangalore Technologies. But the location is Puri. I'm just thinking 10 times to move or not. This is one thing. And even I've also been shortlisted for one company. So these are all the things which I'm just looking at. And of course, I've cleared two rounds in view of Bristol phone, and I'm just expecting the offer letter. So because my core view is I just wanted to enhance my skills. So I'm also into certain training of other basic HR modules to some other candidates. So I'm not interested in this training or something, but I just wanted to enhance my skills. That's what is my more idea.
I was just a comment, means I have given the training as well earlier, that was through online. I never took the classroom trainings.
I'm not thinking of like see, online is good and like classroom sessions are bad. It's not like that. See, we can go ahead with the complete online training, but certain classes which you feel which like the face-to-face interaction with the classroom session maybe the best, that session can be taken like hardly out of 30-40 sessions. We can go ahead with 5 to 6 sessions, so that gives you more addition to what I just feel into.
I will discuss with the Sweetman K.
Certainly, and thank you very much, Nilesh. I'm very quite to it. Really happy, and you have given me fast demo. Explain me the role, responsibility. Thank you. Nice talking to you, and thank you very much. I think, in spite of your bad health condition, like coughing and all, you have been very good, and really thank you. And nice to speak to you, Mr. Nilesh.
Hello. I will contact you tomorrow, okay?
Yeah, certainly.
Thanks for attending demo.
Thank you, thank you.
Nilesh,
thank you, Mr. Nilesh. Have a nice weekend. Bye, guys.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you, Nilesh.